phonetically understood.
Stories in Berlin, Season 3. Hello everyone and welcome to Stories in Berlin Season 3. I am Christina and in this season I read for you chapter by chapter, one chapter per episode, my novel The Berliners, a collection of semi-fictional stories about the life of Berliners during the corona pandemic. All stories take place on the same night in late November 2020 in a lockdown Berlin. Every chapter tells the story of a different Berliner. You shall find Season 3 on iTunes, Google Play, SoundCloud, YouTube and Podbean. If you would like to learn more about this podcast and the Story for Food project with which it is connected, you may visit storiesin.berlin and storyforfood.com. On social media, you may find us at Stories in Berlin and at Story for Food. If you would like to support this podcast and the Story for Food project, please consider a small donation via PayPal at paypal.me/storyforfood. Thank you all for listening. Sergio. Gratitude. Sergio was new to Berlin. He arrived in September 2020 in the midst of the corona pandemic, having left Rio de Janeiro with a one-way ticket. He was 23 years old and he was here to stay. He spoke no German, his English was poor, and he knew nobody in the German capital, nor in Germany, nor in Europe for what matters. Even if he just held the 3 months tourist visa, he had sworn to himself that he would settle in Berlin. He had studied photography in Rio and his dream was to become a filmmaker. There was another reason he was absolutely determined to make it in Berlin. He couldn't go back home. For he hadn't left merely his country, his hometown, his family and friends. He had left himself behind. Or rather, the social facade that he called himself in Brazil, the obedient son of an evangelist politician, of an ultra-conservative, racist and homophobic family. Sergio was homosexual and he had found it impossible to come out as gay in Brazil. He had come to Berlin to embrace his sexual identity and start a new life. On the 26th of September, the day of his arrival in Berlin, he wrote in his diary, "Today I'm born again. This is the first day of the rest of my life." It was not hard to learn the ins and outs of the gay life in Berlin. Despite the pandemic, it was rather easy to online date using the Grindr application. However, after a dozen of casual sex encounters, Sergio started looking for something more, a love story. And it became pretty clear to him that he wouldn't find that on Grindr. In the beginning of November, when all coffee shops, restaurants, bars, cinemas and music venues closed due to the second wave of the corona pandemic, Sergio discovered to his amazement that the Berlin bookshops remained open despite lockdown. He started frequenting a second-hand bookshop in his street, somewhere in South Prenzlauer Berg, going through books back and forth 4 hours every day. Books he couldn't read. It was warm and cozy in the bookshop, a safe place to be alone among others and to meet strangers. If one day he would make a film, it would take place in a bookshop. Maybe even in that small second-hand bookshop, still open in the midst of a pandemic lockdown. Sergio was easy to talk to, and soon Anya, the bookshop cashier, became his confidant. He told her all about his life in Brazil, his escape from his oppressive family, his longing to settle down in Berlin. Anya talked to him about Berlin in the pre-corona days, the street markets, the music festivals, the wild parties, Bergheim and Berlinale. And Sergio fell in love with the city, or better said, with the legend of the city. One day Anya didn't come to work. In her place, Sergio found one of the owners of the bookshop. Nils was in his 40s, little shy, little vulnerable, certainly charming. On that moment, he was going through a rough divorce and he looked rather sad. He had a 5-year-old son, and when Sergio saw them together for the first time, he found Nils to be the most loving and attentive father he had ever seen. The truth is that Sergio was immediately captivated by Nils. They hardly exchanged few words during the week that Nils was replacing Anya at the bookshop, yet Sergio had developed a crush on him by the time Anya was back at work. The obstacle was obvious. Nils was not homosexual. Anya tried to reason her new friend out of his love interest for Nils, yet she failed. Sergio kept going every day to the bookshop, sometimes to go through a book or to buy a postcard, to chat with Anya and to catch a glimpse of Nils. With Berlin in lockdown, his plans to make a short film in order to apply to film schools had fallen through. Now, Sergio would spend his days studying German at home and visiting his favorite bookshop every afternoon. Waiting, like most of us during lockdown. Yet, while we were waiting for the pandemic to ease up, Sergio was waiting for a miracle. One day, towards the end of November, Sergio found Nils alone in the bookshop. Their eyes met for a split second, and Sergio turned away, blushing. The bookshop was empty and it was getting night. Sergio, usually so talkative, was unable to utter a word when Nils approached him to ask if he needed any assistance. Then something unexpected happened. Something so sudden and tiny that Sergio couldn't say if it was true or imagination. For a fragile instant, Nils caressed Sergio's palm as if unintentionally. It all started from there. Sergio hurried out of the bookshop with his heart beating wildly. He didn't go home. He waited in the corner for Nils to also leave the bookshop. He had an odd presentiment that Nils might be more similar to him than he dared to admit. Around 45 minutes later, Nils closed up the bookshop and took the tram back home. Sergio followed him secretly. He trailed him till Nils stopped by his building's front door. For some minutes, Nils didn't move. He just waited by the door. Sergio approached, confidently at first, then less so. When the two men were close enough, with Sergio standing behind his back, Nils turned towards the young man and kissed him softly on the lips. "Are you coming in?" he asked in a hoarse whisper. Sergio looked at him and his eyes beamed. At that moment, he grasped a inner truth that embraces all there is and everything that ever happens. The harmony in fate and life. Sergio realized that everything that had ever happened to him, all the pain and repression he had experienced growing up in Brazil, all the fear and joy connected with claiming his gender identity in Berlin, his fortuit meeting with Anya, even the corona lockdown, had brought him to that moment, to that man, to that love story that was about to begin. everything had come for a reason. And in his mind, Sergio saw the future he had dreamed of, being happy with Nils in Berlin and making a film about the experience of coming out as a gay man within a conservative Christian community. He was beaming with gratitude for everything that night, for Berlin, for Nils and his bookshop, even for the corona pandemic.